What is up, guys? Let's get back into another episode of Let's Play Evo Creo. So, last episode, we just made it out of the cave. Thank God, because that took a while. And what in the hell is that thing? I feel like we have an obligation to catch that big freak thing. Alright, Titus, I've been observing you, and you seem different from other evokers that I have encountered. Remind me of my people, but are you worthy of such honor? Just a surprise battle, I guess. Figures. As our team is, like, kind of effed right now. Cool. You know what? Bumba may be poisoned, but he's got it. He'll be alright. Ooh, we are badly poisoned. No bueno. Let's make quick work of this. Boom, one-shotted. There we go. Super powered. No longer badly poisoned. Has only had one. Really not much of a threat. As I expected, we will meet again. Will we? Nema orb. Oh my god, what is that thing? Fat man. Oh, dude, it's 4 stars. I kind of want to catch it. Sixty-one health. Will this kill it? Probably not. No. I think I want to try and catch it. Because I think it's hilarious. Oh wait, what is it? So it's just normal. This is hilarious. Come on. Hit yourself. I feel like it's way too risky to use hail because I feel like it's gonna kill. Just gonna heal, wait out a turn, see if he hits himself again. Nice. Alright, let's freaking go. Come on. Fudge! It's 4 stars, I don't really want to let this thing go. I bet you it'll be super tanky. Come on. Yes. We caught Fat Man. Ooh, a tome shot. Okay, so the last one was like a Snorlax. Are you kidding me? This is like a freaking Diglett. Valroot. I don't know, man. I just don't know. So the first one I can kind of forgive, because it's kind of funny. But, man, that second... That freaking Diglett clone is just like... Pretty sure I've been at this store before, of course, but let's see what the heck is that. A chip that stores the Tome of Tsunami. T-Script powerful. So the other ones are just like the normal moves, and that one is like the elite move, I'm guessing. Not quite interested. I'll pass. Take a pass. Alright, one thing I do want to do is heal because our team is really not that bad. Never mind. One thing I am going to do, though, is switch... Actually, let's switch Kakachu back in. He is still blinded, but... No pain, no gain, man. Be alright. Fatima Robbie. That thing is pretty cool. Perfect, it's electric, so... We will be able to absorb the electric moves. Dang! Oh, it's because we're blinded. I was like, what in the hell is going on? There we go. Thank you. We're about to hit level 21. I don't quite know if that's enough for another... whatchamacallit, like a perk thing on the skill tree. But we will double check. I think it is. So if we get 1 point per level up, another 10 should be enough. Yes. Let's go. Dunzo. 37. It's not bad, not bad, not bad. Ooh, the showdown. Bad move. That's all it took. Fatima, you fool. Alright, let's go. Kind of want to see how strong this one is. No, I guess not. That one respawn. Oh, we are in the city. There's our building. We're healed. I feel like it is time to get rid of Slith. So let's see, he's a 4-star. Let's just look, so he's primarily attack. What is Fetman? Whoa. So he has absolutely no speed, but a shit ton of health, a lot of attack, and a lot of defense. Evokers who capture Fetman usually end up paying more for food than for training. That's hilarious. Can this thing... Big finish... Oh, okay. Well, I can't deselect it now. Cool. Alright, so... Let's see, what attacks does it know? Headbutt... Crush is a little bit better, is that right? A little bit less accuracy, but more power. I'm okay with that. I don't quite know what I want to name him yet, so we'll kind of just let him sit. Alright, what do we need to buy? We need to buy freaking... healing stuff. Oh shit. Alright. What is... Removes one condition. That's what I want. Screw it, we'll buy 20 of those too. Alright. And Fetman is already level 25, so that's pretty cool. I think it's just hilarious looking. Alright, so that is... Can we swim here? Oh, is this the lab? Let's storm the lab before we take on the tournament. Alright, let's see who needs... I'll keep Kakachu up. Actually, he's going to do good against the water, so I'm all over the place. Let's put Bumba in, because he's not going to get a whole lot of screen time in the water tournament. This area's private. Look at what I'm wearing. Can't you see? Wow. Wasn't I super powered? I guess not. That's fine, I guess. No, I'm really vulnerable. Damn, 34 on like a basic ass move. 38. Ride. Oh yes, that is freaking awesome. That with the sped up distance travel, like I'll just show you guys. You move stupid fast. It's hilarious. Is pretty funny. Alright, so I don't know if I can do it in here. Usually if you have it equipped on him. Let's see. So it's like on the ability, not the trait, so it's not like an inconvenience to have it on him. Oh, I think I have to be outside. I'll just show you guys real quick, because it's hilarious how fast it is. Wow, what the heck? Oh, there you tap on yourself. That is freaking hilarious. We are running on freaking Bumba. God, I wish we could do it in here. That would be hilarious. Alright, let's crush all these people. A few episodes back when I lost, like, pretty much a whole episode's worth of footage... one of the things that I missed was the lab in Carbon City, I want to say. But it was basically just like this so far. So if you guys have never seen it before, this is generally exactly what the first one was like. Shoot. It was just... like the exact same pretty much. I mean, the people were in a little bit different spots, but same basic layout, same pretty much everything. But then like at the end there's like a mini boss battle, I guess you could call it. And then we got that key thing that says it looks like it's part of a set, which makes it very obvious that we need to destroy a bunch of these little labs. I'm not gonna lie though, if I was offered a genetically modified Creo, I'd probably take it. They have very low security. It's just a lab in the middle of town, and they're worried about people coming in when they just leave the door open. Oh, it's a Gina wannabe. Are we ever going to hit that on the first try ever again? Nice. Had to just hang on that little bit. There we go, level 40. Look at that. All stats are in triple digits. We'll keep him in for this last fight. Oh, shoot. Surprised he did that much. That's all you had to offer. Not even an attack, just a status move. Alright, so we're gonna switch in Catcachou now, just because I don't want the main three to get, like, super overpowered. My shift is almost over, and I have to deal with you. Acting like it's just some, like, fast food job. Dude, that thing is so cool. Photon shot. Bite. Such a weak move. I wonder if Catcachou evolves again. Because I feel like that would be a really anticlimactic evolution to evolve into that and then nothing more. Oh, this thing's tanky as shit. Alright, so we resist his attacks. He doesn't resist ours, but that thing is tanky as hell. And now we're poisoned. How much HP does this thing have? This is like this thing's whole strategy, I bet. 155. It's gotta have good defense and high HP. Desperate Strike. Used up all of its moves. Dang. Super tank. Ha. Mame. No. Of course. It knew I was not going to get poisoned, and I knew exactly what to do. Figures. Alright, so we leveled up. That's a good thing. Just got the gloves ready, man. Oh, nice! That thing is freaking cool. That thing is cool. All right, that is totally worth it. Totally worth it. All right, we need to get rid of that poison and stuff though, so let's... All right, yeah, you recovered. I wish it had the... I get spoiled whenever I play Omega Ruby where you could just sit in the item screen and just use like repeated items on someone. Like it's totally like a newer mechanic. Like not a lot of games do that kind of thing. But like everyone who's ever played an RPG before, you just know you once you use the one item, you go back into the freaking item screen and you gotta, you know, do it again. And it was never an issue, but now I've kind of gotten spoiled from Pokemon just being able to just spam like the lower items, like just spam like 10 potions instead of like one hyper potion, just dumping all of your inventory. Because that makes it worth it to collect all the little stuff. Otherwise, it would just be like, just toss it all. Because there's no point in like hoarding these small, insignificant items. Ooh. It doesn't even matter if you're confused, because literally nothing is going to happen of it. Paralyzed and confused. See? Sometimes you'll get a hit on paralysis. I feel like that's a decent mix. But for confusion, you'd be confused and just nothing will happen ever. See? Just doesn't matter. It's confused again. Like probably this third time I think that's ever happened. Yes, he killed himself. As I say that, it's twice in a row. It just wants me to shut up about it. Solar flare. Alright, you got this boss hoe up here. Let's... Bumba, you need some lovin'. I'm trying to sneak around. Dolda. This is the one I was talking about, my queen. Shadowhive queen. I don't want any of your excuses, Dolda. Just take care of it. And she just leaves like we don't even exist. Orc is similar to sharpening our tools. Both humans and Creo benefit from that relationship. You see that, don't you? Oh, Dolda. Yikes. That defense has got to be pretty good. Damn. It's gonna resist it. I think so. Because it was a crit, so I didn't see if it was purple numbers or not. Yep, definitely does. Paralyzed, though. Gonna heal up. Nice. Alright, gonna hit it with the bite. Damn. Let's just try Fetman. Are we outclassed here? Level 37. Let's just go for it, I guess. Oh my god. Earth. Normal. Oh my god, this could be the thing that makes us win this. Just just so it can soak up another hit, and the bleeding will probably kill it. I hit the freaking item menu as it was using a move. Oh my god, literally 1 HP left. Let's just see. Yeah, he'll be able to get... Alright, this is going to be some good experience. 4,000. Nice. No speed. Single digit speed. That's freaking incredible. Just, he's gaining absolutely nothing in speed. He gained one speed there. Earthquake. Dude, if he gains enough levels here, we could actually start using him. Oh, dude, that is... Heals and removes two conditions? Holy shit. Sorry, Fet Man. It was not meant to be. He's burned. Let's go, Squidge. Oh, how many more does he... Oh, it's not going to show me, huh? Let's just hit it with the all-out offensive. Damn. Hail. Really? Dang, 1350 for Squidgy even? Is it because it's like a boss battle or something? That thing is freaking cool. Dude, that is a savage move. What in the actual shit? God, that is an insane move. Dang, that's the elite move, I'm guessing. Damn, this thing is a heavy hitter. Holy shit, we survived. That's impressive. No text available. Key, NPC, Dolda. So is that like a... freaking like a bug in the script or something, so we just don't know what he said, I guess. But we got the beta key, so yeah, I guess that's an awkward place to end it. But we defeated the lab. That was kind of surprising. That was a little bit more challenging than the last one for sure. So, it's not quite so much a walk in the park anymore, which is nice. Anyways, thank you guys for watching. We will take on the tournament in the next episode, so stay tuned for that. Go ahead and smash that like button, subscribe if you like what you're seeing so far. And as always, we'll see you guys next time.